For this test, we're gonna use this web shop, which I created in my YouTube tutorial. It's an official WooCommerce powered web shop with a mega menu over there. It's fully interactive. You can see everything moves when you touch it. We have beautiful backgrounds, also moving backgrounds in here. So this is a running, working web shop. You can go to the products over there. You can actually buy them in here and add them to cart and pay them with PayPal or credit card. First thing we do is we go to wpressdoctor.com/flyingpress or just click over there and then we press enter. The first thing I notice here that the plans actually renew on a way cheaper basis. That's pretty awesome. So we're going to get the developer license over here, press buy now. And we can choose to pay with PayPal or credit card. Gonna fill in all my information and I'm gonna press pay with PayPal. Once you have paid and locked in, you can download here FlyingPress using this blue button. Click on it. We're going to optimize this WooCommerce web shop. To do this, we're gonna use three different tests. The first test we are using, of course, is page speed inside. So go over there, fill in your website, in my case this, and press analyze. The next test we're gonna run is Pingdom. Select where you want to test it from. I say Germany and press start test. The last one is GT Metrics. Also fill it in and press test your site. The results of the test with PageSpeed Insight is not that good. We have not a very good score on mobile, 48, and on desktop we have only a 60. That is because we have not optimized this website at all. So we're gonna test FlyingPress to see how this works. Pingdom is also not very impressed with our website so far. It has a D and it gives us a score of 70. GG Metrics tested it from Vancouver in Canada and it's, well, it's a C. So it could do way better than this. Next step is log into your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP Admin,
no!
Nope.
That's not a very safe way and you don't want to get hacked. So watch my tutorial about WordPress security right after this video. That's what I'm talking about. Security, very important. On our dashboard, we go to plugins over there and we press add new. We press over here, upload plugin. Select the FlyingPress plugin we've just downloaded. And then we press install now. Press activate plugin. It has been activated, well done. Go to FlyingPress over here, go to settings. Welcome to the dashboard of FlyingPress. As you can see, it is very clean, very easy to manage. The thing you can do on your dashboard is actually purge your caches, preload and everything. You can see all these ways of purging everything in caches, but you can also do this up here, which is very easy. And sometimes you actually need it when you've changed some things and you don't see it on the front end. This is the way to change it. Now they also have a CDN. We're gonna test that out in another video. I'm gonna walk you through all the settings of FlyingPress so you know exactly how to set it up and to use the full power of FlyingPress. And then we're gonna test it out and see what happens to our scores. First, we go to cache over here. If you have a lot of people logging into your website, for example, subscription websites, you need to enable this. If you don't have this, keep this disabled. Generate separate cache for mobile. In most cases, you don't need this because all themes are responsive in 2023. However, if you see on the mobile this is going not very fast, we can enable this one to see how it improves our score. For now, we're gonna keep it disabled. Here you can schedule your preloading, which is a very awesome feature. I don't have seen it many times on other plugins. This can be useful if you're using some kind of system that pulls out content from other sources so that it refreshes your own content. Exclude pages from caching. The most important pages that should be excluded if you have, for example, a web shop should be, of course, your cart and your checkout. So we're gonna exclude the cart, but also the checkout, just to be sure. Ignore query parameters. Well, if you're a developer, you could put them in right there. If you don't know what I'm talking about, just leave it empty as it is. Cookies, so you can bypass them. We don't need it. Only if you're a developer, you know what you're doing with placing specific cookies, then just bypass them over here. Press save changes. And then we go to CSS over there. We're gonna minify them, but we also want to remove unused CSS. Let's do it asynchronously. Great. We don't need to exclude any style sheet unless you're a developer, but just keep it in there. Include selectors. We don't need this because everything will be included. And here you can also put in some elements that you want to lazy load it. If you're a developer, you know what you're doing, put it in there or else just leave it empty. press save changes again. Then we go to JavaScript over there. Of course, we want to minify it. We also want to preload it. We also want to defer JavaScript, of course, and we want to do it inline. Well, you have to really test this one out, because it might be that in your theme everything works great and in my theme it's going to break. So let's just turn it on and see what's happening to our website. We can always turn it off later on. And also we want to delay JavaScript, of course. This is the place to exclude some scripts if you want it. Most websites don't put it in here. Delay JavaScript. You can exclude some scripts from deferring it. That could be very useful if you encounter some problems, but most of the time we just defer all of them. You can also delay JavaScript. If you enable this one, you can actually delay them manually or delay all of them. Normally the delay method is to delay all JavaScript. You can also use delay selected, and then there you have created a list with some examples of all kinds of scripts that could be running on your website. In this test, we're going to delay all of them, but if you run into some problems, you can always turn this off. Press save changes. Then we go to the fonts over there. Optimize Google fonts. Yes, you want this. Most websites use a lot of Google fonts, but they have to be downloaded from external servers. But you can also combine them and self-host them, which saves a lot of time and different requests. So this is actually very great. And also display fallback fonts. Excellent. Here you can preload fonts. If you notice on your website that different fonts are loaded later and you can see they're jumping around and changing, here you can add them in so they will be loaded with a high priority. Press save changes and we're going to the next one, images. Lazy load images, this is what we want, because it only starts loading images if you're scrolling down and those images are coming into view of the user. So until that time, it's fine to not load them in, as it saves a lot of time and resources from your server, your website, and the visitor's browser. So that's actually pretty good. This is a feature I've never seen before. You can change the exclude above default images. This is actually a strange option. Why I think it's strange? Because in some pages I can have 5 images above default. So that's what being loaded instantly. But sometimes I only have 1. And I actually want this system for me to see how many images there are to exclude them. We just keep them on 2 and see what's going on our website. Here we can exclude images manually. If you see that lazy loading is not working pretty good with some images, put them in over there and then they are excluded. In this tutorial, we cannot add responsive images using Flying CDN, but I'll be creating a video with Flying CDN just because I'm very interested if it speeds up my website even more. Now we're going to enable this one. It's a very powerful feature to prevent layout shifts, and that's something Google really hates. If you have a lot of members on your website and they're logging in using their own gravatars, then this option is very important. If you don't have users on your website, it's just you, you can disable this one. Preload critical images is very important, because now your logo, for example, will be loaded with higher priority than the lazy loading. So that's very important. Press save changes. And then we go to the next one, iframes. If you have iframes on your website, most websites don't, but if you embed YouTube videos or Vimeo, they have iframes. So then a lazy loading would be very useful, but also a placeholder image for your video, so that the image will be loaded first and then they start loading the iframe behind that, which is important and saves you a lot of layout shifting. And again, that's very important. Press save changes. Then we go to the next option, CDN. Now I've heard some really good things about the Flying CDN, so I'm gonna create a new video about this one. Mark my words. And then we go to Bloat, one of my favorite pieces of FlyingPress, because here we can disable and remove all kinds of things. This is great. If you remove your Google fonts, you can do this, but if you've created your website with great care and you've selected your fonts with great care and it's all Google fonts, if we remove this, then someone loading your website will see other fonts than you do. So it might not be a good idea to do this. Only if you have a very simple blog with just some simple Google fonts and they can be easily by Calibri or Times New Roman or I don't know. In our case, I'm not gonna use this feature because I don't know how it will look on the front end. I really like the next feature, disable WooCommerce cart fragments. This is very useful because it disables the cart fragments on non-WooCommerce pages, which are used to update the cart without reloading. We actually don't need this if you're not on a WooCommerce page, unless you have all kind of integration with WooCommerce on non-shopping pages. So keep that in mind if you have to, don't enable this. The next feature disables WooCommerce scripts and style if you're on your own website and not on WooCommerce pages. Really good feature, let's turn this on and see what happens. Disable XML RPC, which is also a security feature. I don't know why it is in FlyingPress, but I always keep it disabled with my iTheme security tutorial. So this is actually great. Disable it. It's already disabled, so why not disable it again? Disable your RSS feed. If you're a news website and you're putting out a lot of news and content that other websites are following or loading or reading through RSS readers, don't disable this. In our case, nobody does it, so we're going to disable it. Ooh, I really like this feature. Disable your block editor CSS. If you're not using Gutenberg at all, enable this one. It will save you some CSS on your entire website, so this is really great. Then we're going to disable OMS. What is this? Well, it's actually automatic. If you type in a YouTube URL or a SoundCloud URL or Vimeo, then WordPress knows, oh, we can embed this on this way. And they're using a special script for that. If you're not using it or you're using Elementor or Divi or whatever, you don't need this from WordPress itself. So we can easily disable this. Also, emojis. You can disable this if you're not using a lot of users that comment on your blogs using emojis. Please disable this. And disable WP cron. I would not advise you to disable this one because it's actually responsible for a lot of things in your website, including checking for updates and, well, all kind of things that are pretty important. So I do not want to disable this. jQuery migrate. Yes, we can disable this one because it's responsible for backwards compatibility with older jQuery code. This is actually pretty old right now, so we could definitely disable this one. Dash icons can be removed for the front end. Admin interface icons can remove it. Here we can control post revisions, which is actually pretty useful. If you're the only one working on your website, you can control it and put, for example, only store 5 or maybe 10 revisions. But if you're not the only one on your website and you're working with more people, then actually turn this off. Because sometimes people tend to save every little change they do and you have 20 revisions and then you want to go back to the original author because they messed it up. You cannot because you only have 10 up, for example. So if you're the only one, yes, control it and put it on 10. And then the next option is control our heartbeat. The heartbeat API is responsible for auto-saving your posts or pages, for example, when you're editing them. These tend to go every 15 seconds. We can reduce the load on your server and on your website to change it, for example, to 60 seconds. You might say, oh, that's not a lot, but it actually really does make a difference. So we're going to put it on 60 seconds and you can put it on enable only while editing posts. That should be useful. We press save changes and then we go to the next option, which is the database option over there. You can clean your database automatically, which can be done, but is pretty risky. Why? It will delete all your post revisions. It will delete your post auto drafts. It will delete all your trash posts. It will delete your spam contents. It will delete your trash contents, expired transients or all transients. These are options from plugins you removed, so they can be removed, that's safe. And optimize tables. Well, you can do this. But remember, if this system runs and is gonna clean everything, then it's actually gone. You have to restore a backup from your hosting company to get this back. So if you don't know what you're doing, keep this all unselected, keep it on never and save changes. If you know exactly what you're doing, you're a pro user, you can turn this on, for example, on monthly or weekly, whatever you want. I actually don't do this. Once in a while, I do this with older websites that I've created and everything's good. I can remove all revisions and auto drafts and trash posts. That's fine. But on newer websites, while I'm working on them, I never use this. Let's go to settings again. We have the license, which has already been activated because we've downloaded. Excellent. And here you can export your configuration or import it again. and we want to participate in improving FlyingPress so that you can share anonymous data. Well, why not? I want to help them press save changes. Now that's it. We set up FlyingPress pretty easy. Now if we now go back to our dashboard, we will see that 6 pages are cached. You can press this refresh button and then it says, ooh, 7 pages are cached. Nice. And the first thing we're going to do is we're going to visit our site, but we are going to do it in a new private window. Very important. Well, that loaded in pretty fast. Then we're going to scroll down to see if all my effects are still in place. Looks good, looks good. Everything still works. Parallax, my moving background text. Excellent. Well, this looks pretty amazing. My menu still works. Does my shake works? It loads in pretty quickly. Also, again, still works the way it should. Everything seems to be working, so the next phase is let's test our website with the Pingdom, Google PageSpeed, and GT Metrics. How do we do that? We're going to open up this screen in another screen. So you're going to just copy this one, copy it, press Ctrl T on your keyboard, go to a new tab, and run it again over there. Now we have 2 tabs open with PageSpeed Insights, and the next one we're going to press Analyze again. So great. Let it run. Let's go to Pingdom, do the same thing, copy it, open in a new tab, open it again, and we're going to press Start Test. And we have 2 pages, one with a test and one with a new result. Then we go to GT Metrics, latest performance, do it again, open up a new tab, put it in over there, and we're going to press on Retest right there. Here we go. Right, so the results are in, and if we go from the normal without optimization, we have 48 and a desktop 60. Let's go on the new one. We have a mobile 94, which is actually pretty good, but it can be higher, but we have a cumulative layout shift. I should go into this even on desktop. Ooh, the score is only 81. And again, it is because of the cumulative layout shift. It has to do with my video, I think, in my website. However, with WP Rocket, I didn't get these results. Let's go to Pingdom. We had a 70 and a D, and now we have a 95 and an A. Not bad, not bad. GT Metrics said a C 72, and now it says an A in 87, but it's especially because of the cumulative layout shift. It might be fixed when I'm using the CDN. Well, these are the test scores that I got with the combination of Divi, the video, and FlyingPress. Let me know what your results are in the comments, or if you have any questions, also drop them down. I'll always reply. Hit that like button if I helped you out. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more WordPress related videos, and check out this video, which is also pretty nice and going blazingly fast. Blazingly fast.